We'll start a very interesting chapter, that is part 7, coordinate geometry, part 1. So in this part, you are going to see some basic ideas of Cartesian system. You might have studied in 9th class also. Then we will see distance formula. How to derive the distance formula? Derivation of distance formula. Okay, there is problems on distance formula. Okay, so these things today we will see this. So this is very interesting chapter. Okay, so listen carefully. Diagram. Already you know that x, x dash and y, y dash, that is the graph. So in coordinate system, that is what coordinate system, Cartesian system, it is called what Cartesian system. Just recall, this is a Cartesian system, or we can say xy plane, or we can say xy plane, or it is called xy plane, or xy plane. Okay, so you know very well, you take any point on this plane, on this plane, you take any point. Any point I am taking here, this point I am taking. So when you draw perpendicular, that is this distance. This distance is how much? 2. This distance is parallel to y axis. You have to see that is 2. Understand? Now, if you draw from this point, you draw perpendicular to y axis, Okay. So this distance. That is this distance is how much? That is 3. 3 units. Okay. Take 3 units. This is 2 units. This distance only. Okay. Now this point, how will you represent this point? Means first you have to write x coordinate. X coordinate is what? 3, 2. 3, 2. In general, x, y. In general, x, y. X is x coordinate. Y is y coordinate. So here 3 is x coordinate. Here x coordinate is 3. X coordinate is 3. Y coordinate is 2. According to this point, x coordinate is 3 and y coordinate is 2. So the x coordinate, otherwise known as what abscissa is 3, and here y coordinate, otherwise known as what ordinate, that is 2. You might have studied in 9th class also. You remember abscissa means x coordinate, ordinate means y coordinate, that is 3, 2. Okay. So like this in coordinate geometry, the point, we will represent the point. In ordered pair, that is, you have to remember this, the distance is x coordinate, that is 3, this distance is y coordinate 2. Okay, in general x comma y, understand? So now this is x dash means x axis, y dash means y axis. And what is O? O is called origin, that is 0, 0. The point is what? 0, 0. That is center is what? O, that is O is origin, that is 0, 0. It is 0. Okay, so 0, 0. In order to pair, you have to write x coordinate 0, y coordinate 0. 0, 0. Understand? Now, what is the education of x-axis? That is also very important. Okay, basic concept. Always you have to remember in coordinate geometry. What is the education of x-axis? The education of x-axis is always y equal to 0. Is y equal to 0. Understand? Education of x-axis is y equal to 0. And the education of y-axis is x is equal to 0. education on y-axis is x is equal to 0. Understand? So any line parallel to what y-axis means, any line, suppose you draw one line which is parallel to y-axis through minus 3 means that is x is equal to minus 3. This equation is what? X is equal to minus 3. So in general we will write x is equal to k. K is any real number. Understand? K is any real number. So any line parallel to y-axis is x is equal to k. Equation of any line parallel to x-axis is y is equal to k. K is any real number. Okay. Understand? Now, any point on the x-axis, is y equal to 0. So, you take any point on the x-axis, means y equal to 0. Here, what is the coordinate point of this point means minus 1 comma 0. Here y equal to 0. Okay, so any point you take, this point you take means 4 comma 0. This point you take means 5 comma 0. That is basic fundamental. Okay, here you take that is any point on the y-axis. Yes, x is equal to 0. Okay. These points we always have to remember in the Cartesian system in coordinate geometry. Understand? So, very, very useful idea. Okay. Very basic, fundamental also. You will use in the problem this one. Understand? So now we will see very important topic, distance formula. Okay, we are going to derive a distance formula. Okay, you see this diagram, that is x dash, y dash. Okay, y dash. I am taking 2 points on this plane. In Cartesian plane, I am taking 2 points. A is 1 point, B is 1 point. So we are going to find out the distance between these 2 points. Okay, so I am taking the point A as x1 comma y1, B as x2 comma y2. Clear? Now you draw this AE perpendicular to BD. Now what is the distance of this OC? OC is nothing but x1. This is x coordinate. This distance is what? X1. Understand? Now, this distance is y1. Understand? This is y1. Same way, this full distance from here to here. Here to here is x2. Understand? This coordinate is x2 comma y1. Therefore, we draw perpendicular means this distance, this full distance. That is OD. OD is x2. Understand? Now, what will be BD? BD is full distance is y coordinate. Okay, y coordinate from here to here. understand these distances are fully called Y2. Okay, these distances are fully Y2. This is Y2. This one X2. Then this is X1. Okay, this distance is X1. Now we have to find out this distance. Because if you draw perpendicular means you will get a right angled triangle. You are getting a right angled triangle. So when you have right angled triangle means immediately what property you will remember, what theorem you will remember, Pythagoras theorem, right? In a right triangle, Pythagoras theorem you apply means this AB squared equal to BE squared plus AE squared. Okay, so you can find out easily AB. The distance between two points is called AB. AB easily you can find out. So we need AE and BE. So AE is nothing but CD. So CD is nothing but what? This full X2 minus X1. So this distance is X2 minus X1. So this is X2 minus X1 means this is also X2 minus X1. X2 minus X1. Understand? Same way here also. This full distance Y2 means this is Y1 means this is also Y1. Because rectangle, this is nothing but a rectangle. So you will get Y1. So now easily we can calculate this distance. That means the full distance you reduce this means you will get Y2 minus Y1. Now you apply Pythagoras theorem means you will get AB squared. You will get. Understand? So this is called AB is called distance between two formula. Okay, distance between two points. Distance between two points. Okay. Understand? Now easily we can find out AB. So in right triangle. In right triangle, BAB or AEB. In right triangle, AEB by Pythagoras theorem. So 90 degree opposite side, that is hypotenuse side, that is square you take AB square. AB square is equal to AE squared plus BE squared. AE squared plus BE squared. AE squared plus BE squared. Understand? Now you just put what is AE? X2 minus X1, the whole square. X2 minus X1, the whole square. Plus what is BE? Y2 minus Y1, the whole square. That is AB squared. Therefore, AB equal to taking square root, whenever you take square root in the right hand side, you have to put plus or minus symbol, but here not necessary. Minus is impossible. Clear? Distance is always positive, that is magnitude, scalar. Clear? Scalar quantity is always positive. Distance is always positive, right? So negative is rejected. That's why simply write square root of x2 minus x1 the whole square plus y2 minus y1 the whole square. Understand? This is a perfect square. That's why what you can write x1 minus x2 whole square also correct. y1 minus y2 whole square also correct. When you take minus sign means squaring means what? Automatically it will change. Okay. That's why you don't bother about two coordinates. That means you have to take the difference whole square. That is the concept. Difference whole square plus these 2 points difference whole square. Okay. Then you will get a distance. So this is called called distance formula. This is known as a distance formula. Okay, now using this formula, here we will see some problems. Understand? See, now we will see exercise problem. Exercise 7.1, the first problem. Find the distance between the following pair of points. Here is the point given, two pair of points given. Right. Now, two points given. Here, you have to take always A and B. That means you have to name the points. You have to name the points. That is very important. A. Lecture. A, B, 2, 3. And B. Always capital letter you have to take. Okay. Point means you have to denote in capital letter. A, B. Now, distance between two points is A, B. That is distance between two points is AB. That is equal to formula. You have to write formula. Formula says was x2 minus x1 the whole square plus y1 minus y2 the whole square, or y2 minus y1 the whole square. Okay, distance between two points is AB equal to square root of x2 minus x1 whole squared plus y2 minus y1 whole squared. Now, I am taking this point, that is x1. You simply write in the pencil. This is x2 minus y2, right? Therefore, AB equal to square root of, you just replace it. What is x2? 4 minus, what is x1? 2. First what? S coordinate you are subtracting. X coordinate you are subtracting. That is 2. The whole square plus. Now y coordinate you have to subtract. y2 is 1 minus 3. 1 minus 3. The whole square. That is equal to, now just what? Simplification only. After applying the formula, what you have to simplify correctly. That is 4 minus 2 is 2 the whole square. Plus 1 minus 3 is minus 2 the whole square. Minus 2 the whole square. That is equal to square root of 2 square is 4. Here also minus 2 square means that is also 4. So 4 plus 4, 8 is nothing but this 8, you can write it as 4 into 2. So 2 root 2. For 4 square root is what? 2. Then root 2 you keep as it is. Then you have to write unit. Distance means always you write units. It may be centimeter, it may be kilometer, it may be meter. That is distance formula. Therefore, required distance is 2 root 2 units. Okay, for these two points, the distance is 2 root 2 units. Understand? Okay, you see here, you have to notice that this formula, what you can write x1 minus x2. Plus whole square plus y1 minus y2 whole square also. That means what? You are subtracting the x coordinate first. First what? Subtracting x coordinate. So you have to practice that. But every time you don't need to write the formula. Clear? Just what? Find the distance. How to find out the distance in the simple way? I am teaching in the simple way. The shortcut way is AB equal to root over. I am taking this. 2 x coordinate you have to subtract. So always subtracting what? Biggest minus smallest number. That is 4 minus 2 the whole square plus. Now here also these two what? Y coordinate subtract is 3 minus 1 the whole square. 3 minus 1 the whole square. Understand? So what you will get means 2 squared plus here also 3 minus 1 is 2 squared. Understand? So that is equal to 4 plus 4. The same thing you will get. That is equal to root 8. That is 2 root 2 the units. So distance formula means you no need to remember the formula. Okay. Just a concept. You have to remember the concept. What you are doing means x coordinate you have to subtract. Take whole squared. Plus y coordinate subtract. Then take whole squared. Understand? While subtracting biggest number minus smallest number. The whole square you have to do. Clear? So this is a very important idea. You will not do any mistake when subtracting. If you do what biggest number minus smallest number means, you will not do any mistake at all. Clear? Easily, that is very fast you can do. Okay. Now we will see the next one. You see here 2 points given. Always you take 1 point is let A be A be minus 5 comma 7 and B be minus 1 comma 3. Therefore, distance between 2 points, that is A B equal to A B means distance. Distance between 2 points means you see you always no need to write a formula. Okay, that is understood. For this formula, simple formula, they will not give a mark. So what you have to do is you have to write highest number minus smallest number whole square. Minus 5 minus 1, highest number is what? Minus 1. So, minus 1, then one compulsory minus there. Minus of this number, minus 5. The whole square, right? Whole square. Plus, highest number is 7. 7 minus 3, the whole square. These two subtract. That's all. Clear? Then taking square. Now, here you see minus 1, minus of minus is what? Plus the whole square. Here 7 minus 3 is what? 4, the whole square. Now here minus 1 plus 5 is what? 4, the whole square. Plus here 4, the whole square. That is root over 16 plus 16. That is root 32. That is nothing but what? Again, you can write what? Here also you can write 16 plus 16, you can write what? 2 into 16, right? That is 16 plus 16, 32. 32 can be written as what? 2 into what? 16. Now, I am taking this 16 as 4 because root 16 is 4. The root 2 you write as it is. So, 4 root 2 units. 4 root 2 units. Understand? See, now this one you see this unknowns given. Clear? That is given some what? Unknowns. So, what you have to do is you take first what? You can take for a change P, you can take capital letter what P, B, A comma B and a Q, B minus A comma minus B. Now distance between these 2 points is PQ, that is PQ equal to square root of, here also I am going to take what highest minus lowest one. So A minus A means A is big, so first you write A, then minus. Here minus is there, minus of minus plus, straight away you can write A, the whole square plus. Here also you see, biggest one is B, B minus of minus plus B you can write. Understand, straight away you can write, minus of minus plus B, that is equal to, here what you will get means, A plus A, 2A the whole square plus 2B the whole square. Square root of 2 squared is what? 4. 4A squared plus here 2 squared is 4. 4B squared here. So now what you can do is 4 you take common. 4 you take common means A squared plus the B squared. Now this root, 4 alone you take the root. Okay, for root 4, root is what? 2. Into for this, you cannot take root as it is your right. A squared plus B squared. So the answer is 2 into root over A squared plus B squared units. Right? Units. Understand? So easily we can use this distance formula. Understand? So now we will see this second problem. Find the distance between the points. So you take let this point what A or O you take, that is origin, that's why what I am taking O is 0 comma 0 and B A I am taking 36 comma 15. Therefore I am finding distance between distance between the 2 points.
Hello? Ah, yes, madam.
Let O 0,0 and A 36,15. So distance between two points. Distance between the points. Yes, distance is that is OA. That is OA. That's equal to root over. Root over. You see, I am going to do is x coordinate you have to subtract means biggest minus smallest. That means 36 minus 0 the whole square plus 15 minus 0 the whole square. 15 minus 0 the whole square. That's all. Very simple, right? So what you will get? 36 square plus 15 square. 36 square plus 15 square. That is nothing but what is 36 square? 6 minus 216. Yes, 1296. 1296 plus 225. 225. That is equal to root over. Just add it. 11, 12, 13, 14, 5, 1, yes sir, 1521, that is nothing but 39, that is nothing but 39, how to, suppose you don't know means you do long division of it, right, how to do this, 15 is there, so 3, right, 9, then subtract, okay, subtract means how much, 6, 21 you bring it here, this one what, double it, right, the quotient, double it, 6, okay, here what number if you give, 10. Here 1 is the last ending is 1. So 9 you give better. 9 you give. Okay, either 1 you have to give, 9 you have to give. 1 give means not possible. 61, 80, 61, 61 only. Right, 1 if you give means not possible. Right. You have to give more number means that is 9 you have to give. So 9 you have to multiply. This 9 you multiply means 9 sorry, 81 remainder 8. So this 50. That is 62, yes, correctly, exactly coming. So, the square root of this 1521 is root 1521 is 39. Understand? Units, you have to write units. Units. Okay. So, this same problem you can do with the diagram also. See the diagram. Very simple. You mark the point. This is O. Approximate what? O is 0,0. Approximate this A is 36. 36, 15. Approximate here. You just assume that. Okay. Now this OA we have to find out. So draw perpendicular here. Draw perpendicular here. Means this distance. This point is what? 36, 15. Means this is 36 nothing but X. Okay. X coordinate. So on the x-axis, you have to take the distance. Then 15 is this one. So you can use Pythagoras theorem. You can use Pythagoras theorem. Suppose you take this one is what? B. This point is B means you will get Pythagoras theorem. Says what? OA squared equal to square root of 36 squared plus 15 squared. Same thing you will get. Understand? Same thing you will get. So you can do like this also. You can do. Understand? This problem you can use earlier what? Your studied this using Pythagoras theorem to find out the distance between two points. Distance between two points. Okay. So you can use only what one point is origin. Then only you can use this Pythagoras theorem. That is correct. You will get right angle triangle. Then you can use. Understand? Okay. But using the distance formula, very simple. Using distance formula, very simple. Right. Straight away you can write root over x squared plus y squared. Understand? Suppose you take xy means one what one point is origin means the distance between two points is root over x squared plus y squared. Simply you can write. Understand? So this concept you have to remember always. Okay. So now what I will give you same type of problems as homework. Do the homework problems for better practice.